So I believe it is not easy for anyone to face such a circumstance where you are thrown such a harrowing diagnosis upon you, and on top of that you're told that the outcome is very, very grim and very imminent. So it takes a very strong person to absorb all of that and then to respond to it, which he did very clearly, very clearly. So, I mean, she was very clear in telling me what she wanted at the end of her journey, and I'm very happy that everything was according to what she had wished for. I believe that she knew that it was very far and wide, the disease. She was strong. She said, I'm going to fight it. I'm not going to give in, so I'm going to fight it till the end, which she did. She said, I will undergo any kind of treatment that is available and required. I'm not going to deny any treatment to myself. So she went ahead with any treatment, every treatment that was advised to her. She was very clear in saying, I do not wish to be transported back to Pakistan now or later. She was very clear about that. She said, this is home, this is where we moved, this is where I will be forever. She stated that I want to be buried at Meadowvale Cemetery. This is where she is. And she was very clear in saying, I want my funeral to be at Isna Mosque. And this is the particular imam or the cleric. We call him the imam, he leads the prayer. This is who I want to lead my last prayer. And it was he who did it. So I'm glad everything that she wished for materialized. So I guess that, you know, she had a very clear concept of her own illness, the extent of her disease, and the probable outcome also.